I'm going to be making this Japanese toolbox pencil case type thing, but I don't want to use all machine tools. I kind of want to do it all hand tools.
Totally.
I need to get some new tools.
All right, well, I know a guy. Debeldwoodtools.com. This is not a paid sponsorship. I'm making him pay for it if he wants to stay
here. Yeah, I am paying for it. So Aiden, I think I'm after a saw. I know you got some Japanese wood saws here. What do you recommend for, say, a cross cut?
This one. It is a good saw.
This one is because it's a good saw? You idiot. Oh. It looks like a scraper, like a barbecue scraper.
Oh,
I've got it all over my arm. Damn it! This is a piece of American walnut out of the rack. It looks like it's aged a bit. It'll do fine, I think, for this little project. Before we get too far into the video, I just wanted to apologize for all the ambient noise. There's a lot of machine noise, compressors and fans in the background, so I tried to edit that out as best I could. So this is pretty much a freeform Japanese toolbox build. So here I'm just cutting out all the sections of this blank, this timber blank, which is American walnut, and planing it to size and shooting the sides and getting everything square. Be square there, but that's miles out, so I'm gonna just try and square up that guy. So the thickness of this board here is 22mm and I cut it in half here, so I end up with around about 10mm a side, and then you just got to plane it down to the final thickness of around about 7mm, 7-8mm. So I've made the sides, I just cut out the ends. Let's rip this sucker. Let the saw do the work, Scott. There's a murder hornet flying around me at the moment. giving me stink eye. That wasn't meant to happen. Time to start marking it all out, I think. So I've marked these end panels out now, and these are going to be the tenons. So I want to remove these portions right through here. And I'm going to mortise those into the sides. I'm chipping away at these tenons. One thing's for sure is each one's getting better with practice. So with the sides and ends made, now I'm looking to get on with the bottom panels. So it's got an actual bottom and a false bottom on this particular box.
They have tools only. Unbelievable. You having some lunch, mate?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. All right.
Look at these little suckers down there. So I think I'll glue this bugger up now. Here I've used a bit of masking tape just to help stop that glue from spreading around and just eliminates a bit of extra cleanup. This panel I'm cutting right now is the actual bottom. The other one I just put in is like the false bottom. Keeps it nice and square and gives it a bit extra strength. Got some of this mango wood, kind of looks like oak, but I'm going to be using that for some decorative pieces on the box, and I think it looks quite nice with its interesting grain. time now to cut the blocks that sit on top of here and here. So a bit of American walnut's gonna do that. Cut it to length and plane it down, all the rest of it. Part I'm working on now is the lid. It's just showing you there, it's all ripped and rough sawn, so playing it down to size. And I think I'll use 10 degrees for this wedge. Listen to that. Okay, next part. I'm going to use this wood butter here. It's wax and tung oil mix. Wax is on, now just to buff it off. Thank you.
Oh, that's terrible.
A fail.
Right, take two.
Oh.
That's pretty good, yeah?
Yeah, better one. Oh, let me almost get to the button.
What are you talking about? That was almost it. All right, yeah. Come on, closer.
No, just smack.
Oh. Yeah?
Let's have a look at that one.